I-34 female, have a pretty successful career in France, and I'm doing pretty well for myself. I also have a twin sister and younger brother, 28 male, who I thought was also doing well. Unfortunately, with my busy life, I don't get to come to the States and see my family often, but when I do, we have a good time since we have a good relationship. Last week, I came to visit my family and planned to stay for a month since my job will be remote for a bit. It was then when I noticed everything was a bit weird. When I walked through the door, my sister's kids, toddlers male and female, were excited to see me, and the oldest kept saying, "Mama back, mama back." I thought they were just confused since we look alike and they have never seen us in the same room together. However, my brother-in-law, 36, pulled me to the side and told me how my twin sister had left him in late November. She just left one night and hasn't seen the kids or called anyone since. Of course, I was shocked and asked how he and the kids were doing. He explained how they're too young to understand everything, but would like it if I extended my visit and pretended to be their mom since he doesn't want them to experience so much hurt so young. I instantly told him no. I didn't want to pretend to be his kid's mother and carried on with my day. I thought this issue was put to rest until yesterday when my mom, 56, told me how she was extremely disappointed in me for not helping out my brother-in-law and thought I should at least try it for a bit since he's in distress. I honestly don't know what to do. My family's a bit old-fashioned and wants me to help my brother-in-law, but it'll be weird for me to pretend to be my sister and their mom. Am I the idiot? My action might make me one since it seems like I don't care about his kids if I refuse. Holy smokes! Nope! Oh my god, how do they think this will help? Even if you were open to it, bad idea. You have to leave again. It's not like you'd permanently play the role. Oh, these poor kids. Your family needs a wake-up call. And the kids need to be told in an age-appropriate way that mom isn't coming back. Wow. All the love to you and those poor babies. Hopefully you told the kids you were their aunt. If so, don't visit them again until they understand what's going on. It'll confuse and hurt them too much. Not the idiot, but why does no one in your immediate family seem to give a crap about where your sister is right now? Mom says she's disappointed in OP for not going along with this charade. But is she equally disappointed in her other daughter for abandoning her children? And I know OP lives away from her family, but no one contacted her when this all went down? I mean, maybe they aren't that close, but still, they're all way too casual about this. Jesus Christ, where do we start with this? Your sister has walked out on your family. It is not your responsibility to swoop in and play mummy until your brother-in-law figures out he has to deal with the reality of the situation. Secondly, have you not contacted your sister to find out where she is and why she left? How can she have walked out on them over a month ago and your family not have mentioned it? Do you not know where she is? The kids probably won't even remember this all in years to come. Either they'll grow up without her, or it'll be a story they're told at a random family dinner when someone gets too drunk. I haven't been able to get in contact with my sister yet, but brother-in-law said one of his friends might have seen her a few towns over, so I'm going to try to follow that lead. When I do find her, I'll definitely speak to her about this. OP, her husband should be far more concerned about her, if he cared. The fact that he hasn't called the police himself is highly concerning. You pretending would be way worse for the children, both in the short run because you would keep coming in and out of their lives, and in the long run, when they're old enough to understand everything. Old-fashioned American tradition does not explain this. This is not an American custom, and it is not normal or moral to lie to children about their parentage. It's cruel and could easily land them in a therapist chair with major problems. What your family wants is flat-out disgusting, enough to make me question if they're even fit to raise these kids. I can only imagine their lives if it's filled with major lies like this. I hope you all will monitor the situation and call CPS. You are not the idiot for not wanting to damage developing minds. I am a 31-year-old male, and my ex-wife is 29 female. Hands down, the best woman I have ever met in my life. She has such a pure heart and is filled with nothing but good. It's been a cold and miserable 2 years without her, and Lord knows I miss her so much. In 2018, my brother was wrongfully convicted and sentenced to 26 years in prison, his wife filed for divorce and terminated his parental rights within the first month. He lost everything. This destroyed me mentally. He protected me as a child and through our teens while in foster care, and I felt like I had to protect him the same way. I spent thousands on lawyers, checked myself into therapy. I barely spoke. I shut my wife out. I tried so hard to fake being happy, and I couldn't. She knew me well enough, too, so she knew. And I watched it slowly destroy her. One night I heard her just crying, like sobbing, hyperventilating, and it killed me. And I just knew I couldn't do that to her anymore. I told her she deserved better and walked. She refused to sign divorce papers, said, "You're going to get better, and you're going to come back to me where you belong." But we haven't spoken since March 2021. I saw her at the grocery store, and it felt like I lost her all over again when she stopped hugging me. By some miracle, all evidence was reviewed 4 months ago, and they found my brother innocent of all charges last week. I picked him up 3 days ago from prison, one of the best days of my life. So my mom texts me an address and tells me to bring my brother there. When we arrive at this cabin, Mom hands my brother the keys and says, "Mel built this for you." Mel is my wife. Apparently, she started doing the project a year and a half ago, after our separation. She left a note to me saying, "I knew you could do it. Love, M." My brother started saying he wanted to bring her out on a date to thank her, and I just lost it a little. I told him I was not comfortable with that. He argued that I let her go and had no right to be a possessive idiot. Ma says that Mel dropped the keys and the note off the morning I picked up my brother. Am I the idiot? Edit. My wife and brother had no contact while in prison. She told my mother she did this for me. I'm not saying Mel cannot go out and date whomever. I would never say that. It's my brother that I have a problem with. He's made passes at her multiple times when I first started dating Mel. She was never comfortable with his advances. And the first thing he wants to do after getting out of prison is date my wife? He hasn't even asked about his kids. That's why I have a problem. You are the idiot. You left her against her wishes. She's allowed to find happiness elsewhere. Of course you're allowed to be upset about it, but it doesn't change the fact that she's single and your brother is too. Call her. Tell her you messed up and you plan on spending the rest of your life making it up to her, if she'll let you. Then she can decide if she wants anything to do with you or your brother. Are you trialing a plot for a Hallmark movie here or what? How about you double down on your therapy and then start having a conversation about working things out with the woman you love, who it seems still loves you, instead of having spats with your brother? You did leave her, dude. So if you're broken about that, maybe work on resolving it instead of avoiding it. I think that'd be relevant if Mel seemed at all interested in OP's brother, but she's continued to pursue the man she's married to, OP, from a distance he's comfortable with for nearly 2 years. She's so clearly devoted to him and hasn't shown his brother a shred of interest. OP's brother is being creepy and disrespectful to try and date the current wife of his brother, who spent years and thousands getting him out of jail. Not to mention he's hit on her in the past and it's made her uncomfortable. So the only idiot here is the brother, as long as OP reciprocates her effort and more from here on out. This is the coldest thing I've ever read. LOL. OP literally gave up everything trying to help his brother, and he's an idiot? So he doesn't want his brother to get back with his wife and plans to sleep with the woman OP's still deeply in love with? Bro, your ex-wife built your brother a house for you because she loves you. So how about you beat your brother to it? You go take her on a date to thank her and get her back. You are the idiot to yourself if you don't at least tell her how you feel, because she feels the same. My wife and I are Mexican American. I'm third generation, and she came here when she was 8. As a result, she's quite a bit more Hispanic than me, and we've clashed at times because I'm insufficiently enthusiastic about my heritage. After we got married, we agreed that we'd have 2 kids and take turns naming them. She went first and gave our daughter a fairly traditional name, Rosa Maria. Last year, our son was born. I named him Daniel. Ever since he was born, she's been calling him by the Spanish pronunciation of his name, with an emphasis on the end. Kinda like Daniel instead of Daniel, like I imagined. She also calls him Donnie, Well, I call him Danny. She introduces him as Daniel to everyone else. And now everyone's just following her pronunciation, which is frustrating because it was my turn to name the baby. And I feel like she doesn't respect my choice. When I confronted her, she says she doesn't want her kids to have anglicized names because they're Mexican. I mean, it's not that I have a problem with them having Spanish names. I don't call Rosa Maria Rose or Rosemary, but it was, as agreed, my turn to name Daniel, and she should respect the fact that I didn't factor in our heritage while naming him. Am I the idiot for wanting my son's name pronounced the way I intended it to be pronounced? You are the idiot. You name one kid, I name the other, is just unrealistic. You're both parents of your children. You get an equal say on the name of each of the children. She's not calling him by a different name. She's calling him by the name you gave him, as it would be pronounced in the culture she's from. Disrespecting your choice would be calling him by a different name entirely. If you wanted a name pronounced the same, or very similar in both Spanish and English, you should have chosen one where that was the case, like your wife did. Not the idiot. And I'm shocked at all the votes going the other way. Firstly, have any of you all met a person who immigrated at 8 years old before? They generally have zero accent speaking English, and in the vast majority of cases, they are way better at and more comfortable speaking English than their native language. Secondly, pronunciation is an integral part of a name, and I don't know why we're all suddenly pretending otherwise. There are names with multiple valid pronunciations, even in the same language, and the correct pronunciation is whatever the person, or their parents if they are a baby, says. So it would be wrong and super rude for people to call them by a different pronunciation, even if the alternate pronunciation is also a common and valid one for that name. Not the idiot. I get it is frustrating hearing your family pronounce it differently than you intended, but I don't know if the pronunciation of his name is a hill to die on. Eventually, when your son gets older, he will have a preference as to how he wants his name pronounced and his nicknames. I have a coworker who goes by Joshua and refuses to go by Josh. He will correct you on the spot if you call him Josh. I have been living with my girlfriend for the past 6 months. We're both in our early 20s and have an overall great relationship. Before our relationship began, I was a big fast food eater. An intersection in my city hosts 7 different fast food restaurants, and I frequent basically all of them. Since I do shift work, I'm generally off the clock at around 11 a.m., and then being too tired to cook, I'll hit up a burger joint for a cheeseburger and some fries. My girlfriend always wants to have exactly one bite of every item I order, exclusively the first bite. When I noticed this, I would start by contacting her on my way to the restaurant, asking if she wanted something. Her answer was a consistent no. But when I get home and dig in, the crinkling of a fast food bag is like Pavlov's bell to her. She'll immediately beeline straight for whatever I'm eating and ask if she can have a bite. I asked if I could leave a little at the end, but no, she wants the first bite. I pleaded with her just to let me buy her food, but no, she doesn't want to eat that much. I've tried ordering a bit more and letting her polish off the whole burger, but no, she'll turn every item into a sampler platter and then throw away the food I bought for her after the first bite if I don't eat it. I don't like it. I don't like this bizarre culinary version of Prime Noctis. For the past few weeks, I've been eating in my car and discreetly disposing of the wrappers. I was just telling her I wasn't hungry after work, but the other day she found a garbage full of fast food wrappers in our bin on garbage day, and she's furious at me for lying to her. Am I the idiot for not sharing with her? Not the idiot. Stop hiding. Tell her if she wants food, you'll buy it for her. But her having to have the first bite of anything you eat is over now. If she wants to be mad over it, let her be mad. It's weird. It's like she read a 1996 issue of Cosmopolitan that taking the first bite of your boyfriend's meal is adorable and men love it, but that she would be thought of as fat and gross if she ordered her own. If she orders food and only takes a single bite and tosses it, then she's only got food if she pays for it herself from now on. Not the idiot, OP. This is the most bizarre flex I've ever seen someone pull. She probably started doing this as something cute and endearing, but now it's a real problem in my opinion. This isn't like stealing a fry while you're already eating. This is saying you can't eat until she does, no matter what. I say eat when you want, And if she wants something, she can have her own. Share on your terms. I assumed that she wanted to eat fast food, but for whatever reason, maybe a diet or a deeper disorder, she avoids and just uses the first bite thing as a way to sort of cheat the system while still having a taste. Anyways, OP, you need to put your foot down. You should be able to eat your food without her controlling and making this ridiculous rule of eating the first bite. Let her be upset until she realizes that it's very selfish of her to take food from someone when she says don't bring her anything. If she doesn't respect your boundary, I would end the relationship. She's being selfish and weird. I have a stepsister, Claire, who I really haven't seen since she left for college at 18. I see her at the occasional holiday dinner, but we have no relationship. Honestly, I can't stand her, and just everything about her personality is ugh to me. My mom married Claire's dad when we were teens, and Claire made it very clear she wasn't interested in being a family. She was very standoffish, and she was kinda mean. She mostly kept to herself, but made it clear she thought she was better than us. We had a couple of vicious fights, but I don't really have bad feelings towards her at this point. I just don't like her. Claire got engaged a few months before me and set a date for September. I'm not invited, which is expected. When I got engaged, I immediately knew where I wanted to hold my wedding, and the closest date I could get to what I wanted was Claire's date. So I figured it would be fine. We have no extended family, no mutual friends. My mom could go to mine and her dad could go to hers. Neither of us is close to the other's parent. I picked the date because I didn't want a winter wedding, and the other ones were too close to December. When I told my mom, she flipped out and said I was humiliating her by making her come without her husband, which is equivalent to not letting her have a plus one. She said my dad would be there with his wife, and she would look like a loser who can't get a man. Everyone knows she's married. She said the wedding wouldn't be fun for her without her husband, and how could I be so selfish? She also is annoyed that my stepdad will be at Claire's wedding without her, with his ex there. Am I the idiot? You are the idiot. You may not care if your mother's husband is at your wedding, but she cares. Not only that, but guaranteed your sister will be angry about this and will accuse you of doing it intentionally, which will probably cause problems in your mother's marriage. It may be your wedding, but the world doesn't revolve around you, and other people's feelings matter. So either reschedule or tell your mom there will be no hard feelings if she doesn't come to your wedding, because you should have never put her in the position of having to choose. You are the idiot. To be honest, it seems like you did this to spite her. Did you think your mom or her dad would want to go without each other to either wedding? I'm not for keeping dates, but you knew the date. You share families, like it or not, and you seem like you really don't like her, so you didn't care. I mean, you don't have to like her, but this was a stupid move. Out of all the 365 days of the year, you picked the same one, so you couldn't just, I don't know, pick the next available date your venue had available? Unless you have terminal brain cancer and have to get married before you die, I can't see how having it a few weeks or months later is even an issue. You're forcing your mom to pick between you two and straining her marriage. If I were her, I would tell you that stepsis set her date first. I thus have a prior engagement and send you a nice card instead of attending your wedding.